Busted on a major felony. What's this guy's demeanor?
He's a little fucking agitated. He ripped the phone out.
I got to go face to face.
No, I don't think so.
Sam, you got a building full of hostages. One of them is hurt. You don't know how bad. Listen, I pulled out the telephone. The SWAT said you got a gun or something like that. If SWAT goes in there, you're going to lose one person, possibly two. You got to let me go in there and look around and make sure things are ready in there.
I don't know.
Sam, look at the guy's rap sheet. There's no violence on there. The guy's never offed anybody. Hey, look, are you going to let me go in there? We're going to stand around and talk and let this guy bleed to death.
Right.
Do something like that. Be a roof and a rifle any day.
CP, I see a WMA in window 3 holding a handgun to Asian female's head. Suspect is wearing a black vest and t-shirt.
I'm gonna kill somebody! If they don't give me my goddamn gun, I'm gonna kill somebody! Who the fuck are you, man?
Hey, how you doing, Earl?
Just donuts, okay, Earl? Relax.
Kick him over.
Okay.
Hands up! God damn it, let me see you. Kick it over, man. Kick it over. Pick it up. Pick it up. Pick it up. Open the back. Show me what's in the back. Open it. It's donuts, man.
That's what I said, man. I told you it was donuts.
It's bullshit, man. You're poisoning that shit. You put like fucking powder in shit,
man. No, no, no. Earl, look, I'm not playing with you. Just donuts.
Eat it. Eat one.
Please, eat. Don't even worry about the donut.
Eat the donut!
Let him eat it. See?
Where's my fucking car, man?
I'm getting you your car, but first things first, all right, Earl? We have to do this thing right, all right? Okay, Earl? I want you to take that gun and point it away from what your name is?
Debbie!
You point that gun away from Debbie's head, okay?
Debbie's fucking brain's gonna be all over the floor in 5 minutes. You'll give me my
car, man.
Girl, that's the worst thing you can do. It's a really bad move if you do that, okay? Let's be clear about something. If you kill anybody, I can't help you.
Right? Please, God. Can't help
you. Rules of the game change then. SWAT will take you out if you kill somebody. That's what they gear up for.
Please,
ready to do you right now. I want you to see something. Come here. Just look out the window here. Look across the street. There's a sniper in the window. He's looking at you right now in a scope on his rifle. The window next to it, sniper in there too. All around the building. You got SWAT on the roof. They've been given the word. You kill anybody. Anybody. They take you out. And they don't give a shit. They'll take you out and go right to lunch, okay? Fuck! Fuck!
What are my chances, man?
Not bad. You know, last month somebody robbed a bank in Daly City. He made it all the way to the freeway. Cops gave him a car, got on the freeway, and he lost it.
Really?
But they didn't kill anybody.
Hey, what did you do that, man?
Okay, Earl, I gotta take Harold out of here. He's bleeding pretty bad. Yeah, I took an oath as a negotiator. If I ever go into a hostile situation and there's an injured party, I'm duty bound by that oath to take the person to safety. Now, you can shoot me if you want, but the next negotiator's gonna tell you the same thing, all right?
Just give me my car, man, all right? Give me my car.
Everybody, everything's gonna be all right. We get everybody out of here, okay?
You give me my car, I'll do it, man. I'm fucking
just let go. All right? And Earl, take that gun down from Debbie's
desk. Listen.
You don't wanna have any accidents.
Fuck with me, man.
Things gonna be cool.
Give me my car, man. Shut up. Come on. Let's go.
That's one out. 17 to go.
Okay, Harold. Here you go.
You guys, what? You got it.
Man, that's shooting anybody in 3 years.
Why not keep the streak alive?
It's a straight out junkie's gonna kill somebody.
What the hell are you doing out there? What's going on?
Harold's going to safety. Everything is cool. We're going to get everybody out of here. But first, to show good faith, give me another hostage. Give me that.
Give me the old fucking man, man.
He don't count, man. He was bleeding. He was going to die in here. That would have been on your ass. I did you a favor taking him out of here. Now give me a hostage. Give me Debbie.
Get me a car, man.
I'm going to get your car, but give me a hostage. Come on, give me Debbie, man.
Take that, man. Take him. Take him.
Okay,
take
them.
Take them.
Go.
We're gonna get everybody out of here. Everybody relax. Let me get your car right now, okay?
Get, car,
get your car right now.
Get me my car, man.
Get your car. Oh, it's one other thing.
What? What?
You want a hard top or convertible?
Hard top, man. Hard top.
Hard top,
man.
Hard top. All right. Manual automatic.
Automatic!
Please, ladies and gentlemen, the inspector is not available to answer your questions right now. We're just very thankful nobody got killed in this incident.
Can't you give us something, Kevin?
Now, the inspector will be available to answer your questions in 2 hours at the official police briefing.
Okay,
police
okay. Are you okay? Please,
please, we have...
Saturday, me, you, and Troy, we go to the park. We have the most beautiful day. One big happy family.
No, you and Troy. We spend enough time together. Troy needs a man in his life. And besides, I'm seeing Greg on Saturday.
What do you mean you're going out with Greg on Saturday? You're going to go out with Greg, and I'm supposed to go out with Troy to the park? You know, that's a little tacky.
Tacky?
Yes, that's tacky. And it's going to confuse Troy. You don't think so? Look, can I drive you to the paper so we can talk about this? Please? Can I drive you? Huh? Hey! Hey! Hey, that's my car!
How are we going for the night?
Two on the floor.
Who am I here?
Dinner's on you.
We got something to deal. I gotta meet with Solis.
Okay, go get him.
Later on.
No. Okay,
so absolutely. Yes, sir, I agree with you 100%. Yeah, you just walked into my office. Chief says, good job this morning. Congratulations.
Oh, well, tell him to give me a raise then.
He said, thank you very much, Chief.
Know what I said?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, I'll discuss it with him right now. Yes, sir. Goodbye, Chief. Robert.
What?
It has been decided that you will take on a new partner and train him to be able to take over for you.
Is that why you got this guy in a Sunday school outfit sitting there in the lobby?
His name is Kevin McCall.
Oh, Captain.
Every Metro captain agrees that he's their best sharpshooter and the most likely to succeed.
This is bullshit, Captain. That's high on his intellectual aptitude, isn't it? Not as high as me, but pretty high.
That's true.
National Marksman's finalist, attended NYC, went to college.
Very impressive.
BI Sniper School, ARO Commendation, additional skills, biathlete, marathoner, lip reading.
This is great. Don't you send this guy to the Marines? He's not negotiating. He'll quit in 2 weeks, Captain.
You let me worry about that.
Well, I hope it's going to be some kind of expression of y'all's appreciation if I got to hang out with Huck Finn over here.
What kind of appreciation you have in mind?
Honestly?
$5,000. Okay, I can do that.
And a car.
I'm not giving you a goddamn car. I just gave you a $5,000 raise. Get your damn car.
Well, Captain, I've been down to Impound and sold what you got there. You got a beautiful black Benz just sitting there right now. Nobody's doing nothing.
Impound is not a rental car company.
The car's part of the deal. I don't have a car.
Well, what the hell happened to your Trans Am?
They repoed my shit this morning.
I'm not promising you nothing, but I'll see what I can do.
As cool as you can. Oh, and I get to keep all the money even if this guy quits. That's why guys don't have the temperament or the background for what I do. Okay, Captain, you know what I'm saying? Hey, how you doing, man? I heard some nice things about you.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to working with you.
Yeah, it'll be good.
Then you got a lot of hard work in front of you. You're going to be a negotiator.
No, I'm up for it. Don't worry. I'll be around longer than 2 weeks. So don't worry about that, okay?
I mean, don't be reading my lips. You should just save that for when you're in sniper school,
okay? Well, don't worry about what I'm going to do for the next weeks, okay?
Can we move past this?
We got past it. We're just getting acquainted with each other.
I'm fine.
Well, I think that's very nice. Now, if you both excuse me, I do have other work to do.
My bad. We gone. Thank you, Captain.
Robert.
Sir.
About the transportation issue. See the inbound, sir.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it. So, have you ever been in a hostage situation?
Only at the very end.
Yeah, what you feel like after the shooting?
Like it has to be done.
It very rarely has to be done.
And it very rarely you shot anyone.
Yeah, well, SWAT is a life-saving unit. Remember that.
No, I know that, okay?
You know, Elijah, you're a wise-ass. Excuse me, you remember when I said you're a wise-ass, and I got a special little test for first-aid wise-asses. Here, look. I want you to get this cap out of the bottle without touching, without destroying the bottle, okay?
Don't move.
And what's the point?
It's a little test of lateral thinking. The obvious solution isn't always the only solution. You got options.
With your head, with your mind,
don't break the bottle.
Okay.
Have a nice day.
Okay. No touching.
Good. Don't look at me. I want the public still.
Great. Great. Thank you.
Mind if we make a stop on the way? We busted Frank Antonucci on possession. He gave us a lead on the Polk Street jury heist.
Phony Frank! Don't waste your time. That guy fingers first born to dodge a collar.
Still got to do it. Wasting time is half my job.
Yeah, all right.
Thank you.
fly. This is it. What? This is it. This is your ride. No, that's not my ride. This is my ride over here. This black car is my ride. No. The black one is mine. That's what I'm. This is my ride. This is your ride. Oh, come on now. Who am I? Red Fox? I can't roll in no shit like that, man. What's up, Sam? That shit's not funny, Sam. I gotta roll around in this shit all week.
Man, where's your stereo?
Never mind the stereo. What's that smell?
Oh, man, just get in. Come on, we ain't got all day.
Man, this truck smell like fish. Fish and shit.
Apartment 304.
You want me to come up with you?
Nah, I probably won't turn up anything. I'm just gonna talk to him.
Good, because I don't look late.
Hey, you want anything on hand? What's the number?
It's Warriors plus six.
I'll take half of your action.
Well, that's a very smart name.
Hurry up, man.
Sam Baffert from the San Francisco Police Department.
Is everything all right?
Can I come in? I would just like to ask you a couple of questions.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. Thank you. Nice. Very nice.
Thanks.
Count Basie.
Ellington. Things ain't what they used to be. It's recorded on July 30th, 1945.
Yeah. Now I can hear it. Where did you find an old recording like that?
It's a used record shop on Turk Street called Memory Lane. Actually, when you're looking for a rare Robert Johnson.
Yeah, I think I know the place. I'll have to get in there.
Sure.
Mr. Corbin, do you know a Frank Antonucci?
Guy who owns the bakery down the street?
No, this is a different Frank. This is a man who deals in jewelry. Stolen, usually. You wouldn't know anybody like that.
No, I certainly would not.
No, it's just a little something here. Could I have a little water, please?
Sure.
Thank you. The reason I'm asking you is because we arrested him with some stolen jewelry. We traced it back to a robbery of a store down on Polk Street. He said he was fencing it for you.
Obviously, there's been some mistake. But I gotta level with you. I got this cousin. There you go. He's had a lot of run-ins with the law. I wouldn't be surprised if he's trying to entangle me in this situation. It wouldn't be the first time.
And this cousin of yours, what's his name?
Clarence Teal. Believe me, they'll know what I'm talking about. Your cough seems better.
Oh, yes.
$200, I'll take the points. Yeah, okay.
Hello, Jeff Stone. This is Lieutenant Samuel Back. I'm at a suspect's residence. I'm requesting a telephone of search warrant. There's visible evidence of the premises of glass seen on the old jeweler's markings. That is correct, Jeff Stone. I believe a full search of the premises will show us the
thank you. action, all of our forces will be brought to bear. We will get there. Get in here, I'll tell you. The chief wants you to know how sorry he is. He said he was just going up to talk to me. He said... I want to be put on this case.
I can't be there.
But I want to be put on this case.
You know damn well I cannot assign you to this. You're much too close to it. You're too close to Sam. You let the department handle it.
But who's running it? Roper? Who's running it?
Kimura and Blass will head the investigation. Scott, go home.
Okay, check on it.
You got another son of a bitch.
Let me get back to you. Sola said to keep you out of this.
I don't give a shit what Sola said. Anybody get any information on this fucking quarter, you tell me about it.
Should be.
You heard about what happened?
Yeah. Sorry.
Can I help him for a minute? Is that a new picture?
It's about 4 months old. I've been working a different style.
Hey, Troy! How you doing? What are you doing? Did you miss me? Huh? Did you miss me? Huh, Troy? Did you miss me?
Yeah. I'm kissing me. I'm kissing
me. No, I don't do that kissing.
Need somebody I can talk to.
Must be pretty awful. You don't usually talk to someone who hurts you.
It was my fault. I was right downstairs. All I had to do was just go up. I was right there.
Scott, you can't save everyone.
Yeah, well, I've definitely proved that tonight for sure.
I don't even know why I came up here. This is a total waste of my time. Where'd I put my keys? Where'd I put my keys?
Scott, what do you want from me?
Obviously something I can't have. Expecting somebody? This night's just getting better and better.
keys.
They're here on the table where you always leave them.
Hey, baby, I thought you.
Hey, Ray Barnett. Excuse me.
Man, he said he had the cops paid off.
Not the cop that showed up at my door!
What happened, Mike? Mike. Sorry, Mike. 2 days. I got a take in that fucking store. Now I can't even show my face. I got a couple of $1,000, Mike. If you need to leave town, right?
Leave town, they're gonna know me in Des Moines by now! $10 million, Clarence! $10 million! I could have disappeared! I could have had it!
That's all right, Clarence. I'll just stick around and take care of you for the rest of my fucking life. Did you kill him, Mike?
Check for DMV about being the registrar.
It's been faxed over now.
How about the record room? For any incident reports that they've been victim, we can get medical records. And have somebody check the burglary detail, see if they know him, if anybody knows how to get on to. And bars. Check with his neighbors and find out what kind of bars he used to frequent.
Scott, we're into it.
I'm into this shit.
We've already had this conversation. You are not active on this case.
Yes, sir.
It's in everyone's best interest.
Y'all are doing good work here.
Yeah, sorry about your friend. I lost some money in the SWAT. I know it's rough.
Appreciate your concern. Let's just leave it at that. What's this your report?
Strategies and countermeasures in hostage situations.
I don't have too much progress with this thing.
Oh, wait, no.
You really had me stumped.
See, no force was required, no damage was done.
All right?
Thank you.
0% chance of survival because he thought his odds were better. You know, we had a plan. The SWAT opened the fire too early and Perk took out my partner. You remember this. Always use your eyes to keep that connection. That's the most important thing. It's like hypnosis.
Right.
You connect with them. You're always on their side.
Okay.
How much money you got on you?
What's that?
How much money you got?
Oh, like $100. Why?
You know, I like coming to the track.
Yeah, you're a compulsive gambler.
Now, a multitude of possibilities. Everything is here for you to see if you just know what the conditions look for. Mm-hmm. Just like a hostage situation. Like you see the four horse?
Mm-hmm.
Dropping in class, no work, front rack, still all broken down. You wouldn't bet on him, right?
Right.
Wrong. You bet on him. See the woman right there with the big belt buckle? That's the owner of the horse. And that belt buckle is a championship belt buckle. She wouldn't come down here with a fancy buckle on unless the horse was alive. You go in here.
That's how you pick your bets by belt buckle?
Well, just trust me. That's you good. See the horse next to that? That's the favorite over there with his tail up, looking all washy, foaming in the mouth, looking all rank and shit.
Uh-huh. It's
supposed to be the favorite. He didn't feel like running today. We don't go in there. Okay.
Okay.
And the six horse looks great. The shiny coat, that bouncy walk, that horse is alive. And that trainee jockey combo, you can't lose on that. What do you think?
I got two words for you. Seek help.
Oh, and I have three words for you. Exacta.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Okay, we're in good shape. We're in good shape. Six horses last. Don't worry about that. That's in style.
Don't run last.
You're running late. See? The favorite's fading. The four horses in the lead, just like I said.
The guy is still last.
Don't worry about that. You're breaking the point goal. Come on, let's take four. Come on, Russell.
We need 30 seconds.
First and second. Come on, Russell.
Today we are winners. Pay the winners, please. Oh, Benjamin. Benjamin looks so sad. I'm in such a wonderful mood, Benjamin. Here you go, here's your share. Benjamin, that's only three.
What?
You got good eyes. It's part of your training. I was making sure you do. Hello. Okay, I'm on my way.
Two dealers, two salespeople, and manager security. Oh, Joe. I'm Inspector Roper. How you people doing in there?
Good.
Solis is off the job now. I'm the guy who's authorized to give you everything that you know. But first, I gotta come down there and talk to you.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do, Joe. I have to come down there and I have to talk to you to make sure there are no misunderstandings and make sure nobody's hurt me before we can take care of business.
All right, Roper, you want to come, come.
Listen, Joe, I'm not armed, okay? You gotta operate on trust here. I'm not armed. I'll come down there and talk to you and get you guys out of here as soon as possible.
5 minutes.
This is obviously a positive job. It sucks. I can be sure the guy won't shoot him.
He can't. Right there.
Where my hands at?
Where I can see him. Roper, and you're in charge, right?
Yep.
Glad you listen up. I say this one time. I want a four-wheel drive vehicle, new, perfect condition. I want a uniform cop. Drive it up right here. You leave the engine running. He walks to the end of the block. Then we'll come out. I know all the tricks. I know remote control devices, okay? When I say perfect condition, I mean if it's low in wiper fluid. Someone gets shot, we'll start again. I want a plane waiting at the airport. I'll tell them where I'm going when I get there. Is that all? No, that's all.
Hey, Joe, you're going to get all those things, but first you got to do something for me. Won't you let me come inside and take a look around, make sure everybody's all right?
You just do shit for me right now.
Wait a minute, Joe, I'm doing a lot for you, okay? You got to do something for me. You got to show act of good faith. Let me have one hostage.
I'll give you something.
One fatality on y'all. It was gunfire to set the fire alarm. I think this guy's working by himself, because the whole time I was talking to him, he had a hostage and he had a gun to her head and he wouldn't leave the doorway. He's got a real calm and creepy demeanor. The guy's a fucking whack. The scariest thing about him is he indicated familiarity when I take notes. So what do you want to do? You want to go in there and get him away from him to come out?
Let him come out. There's too many unknowns in there.
He's right.
Show me.
When we drive up the car, make sure it's at an angle about 3 feet away from the curb. We put our best man high ground. Is Anderson here?
Yes.
Good. Okay, 20 degrees down angle.
Bill Anderson, the prep, and notify us when he's online.
I can feel this thing going sideways, Anderson.
Well, there's some good news. He's wearing a ski mask, so he's protecting his identity. He hasn't determined whether he's going to kill the rest of the hostages. Yet.
Thank you.
Sit down!
She's not conscious by the time I'm done. She's dead. Okay, it's time to give this wacko a call.
How come he's not answering?
Wait. There's your answer.
Thank you.
SWAT. Ready? What if we got into a struggle and my gun went off? Forgive it. Forgive it.
Run! You got it. Put the gun down. You got it, man. Put it down. Come on, man. Put it down.
You were at the press conference.
I want to get this out of the way first.
Have you got a bet on the game tonight?
As a matter of fact, I do have a bet on the game tonight.
Of course you do. Then you'll know it's already started.
Well, I was going to catch the last half on TV later on.
Now
Having dinner with Mr. Baseball?
Greg is actually on a road trip. I was just going to go home and make myself some pasta.
You go home and make some pasta? One with the garlic and the oil that I like so much?
No, the kind you get out of a box. The macaroni and the cheese.
The instant macaroni? I've been craving this stuff all.
Pepper, stir it briskly. Are you listening? You stir it briskly. Then you need lemon. I need lemon.
Should be one in the fridge.
Lemon in the refrigerator.
You know the last part of the game's on.
Oh, really? What game is that?
Oh, you are making an effort.
That's right, and I'm going to win, too. I'm going to be the victor. I'm going to score. Metaphorically speaking, of course, I mean, like, really score, you know.
Just dinner, remember?
I know the rules. Just dinner. Okay, I got this lemon in here. Now, when you taste this, I want you to know that you're going to be experiencing culinary perfection in this company.
Calm down. Give me your background on this. This is the bomb salad dressing that I bring to all the cookouts when my family gathers. They say, Scott, bring Scott. And Brett,
taste this, huh? Is that not the bomb? That is the shit right there.
Honestly, something's missing.
Oh, no, that's not missing anything. You're just jealous because you don't know how to see in the UK. They don't teach you how to make this, see? This is perfection. It does need a little sugar. Why don't you put your finger in there for the proper sweetness?
Scott?
It's a joke. It's a compliment to you. I could have said you could watch put your ass in this bowl. That's a joke. These are all sweetness. John, see how you're offended because that's a compliment. If somebody told me to put my ass in the bowl of salad dressing, that would be complimented. What would you say if I gave up gambling?
I'd say you'd be miserable. It's not so much the gambling, it's more what the gambling got in the way of. The track is where you would take your troubles instead of sharing them with me. Scott, do you remember when you lost that hostage on Union Square?
Yes, I do.
You came here that night, and you made love to me, and it was so intense and so passionate. But you hadn't even talked to me. I didn't even know what happened until I saw it on the news the next morning.
No, that's because I don't want you to be part of that world, right?
Yeah, that's the point. It's not that world. It's your world. It's part of who you are.
Look, Ronnie, it's not easy for me. I know I can't change overnight, but listen to me. I know that I miss you. I don't ever want to be without you.
I'd really like to believe you.
Believe me?
Huh?
Nobody asks you anything.
Officer McCall, what's going on?
What the fuck do you mean what's going on? I'll tell you what's going on. I'm about to fucking waste everybody in here, pal.
Okay, I'm a hostage negotiator. I'm here to help you.
How the hell are you gonna help me, pig? Screw you, man. Fuck you, dude.
Well, I want you to tell me what you need.
What
I need? I'll tell you what I fucking need, man. I need you to fucking find that dirtbag that fucking ran off with my wife, dude, so I can cut his fucking balls off, man.
Okay, I can't do that.
You can't fucking do it? Why am I wasting my fucking time with you, man? You piece of fucking frog shit, piece of shit asshole!
Hey, hey, is all the name calling necessary? I don't like the verbal abuse.
Well, no, not really, but I'd like to throw all that in there, you know, to kind of give it the nut drive me out, you know?
I'm Officer McCall. I'm unarmed. Just want to make sure everybody gets out of here safely.
Okay, stop right there. Close your eyes.
Okay.
Tell me what you see.
I see a scumbag behind the counter with a sawed-off 9mm tucked away in his waistband. There's a female hostage down in front of the cereal rack with a red polka dot dress. Another hostage 3 feet to her right with blue jeans and a checkered shirt. It's not my thing.
But don't give me any shit, Clarence. I'm in it because of you.
Mike, come on, man. You know, you were just robbing the store and he was doing his job.
Fuck you!
Oh, Mike, I carried you your whole life. Hey, you needed money. You needed a place to stay. You were strung out to bail. This time you are there for me. You don't do this to me, please.
You do it!
I can get away with it, Mike.
You just fucking do it!
Thank you.
anybody else I know, I swear to God, I'm gonna find a way to get mad. I'm gonna bust your fucking ass. And I'm gonna put my gun in your mouth and blow your fucking brains out. You understand?
I know what you're talking about.
You know what the fuck I'm talking about. Don't fucking play games with me. You know what the fuck I'm talking about. You know what the fuck I'm talking about? See this guy here? That's your cousin, right? Well, the guy with the white gloves on is the coroner. That's what the fuck I'm talking about. I'm talking about not playing with me, motherfucker. Don't fuck with me, man. I'm not playing with you.
Naples has an expression, when you think you're fucking them, they're fucking you.
Well, you know what? You ain't in motherfucking Naples right now. Fuck that Naples shit. Did you hear what the fuck I just told you?
I don't give a fuck about anything or anybody. Not now. Least of all, a nigger cop interferes with what's mine. And what is mine is $10 million worth. You come in here, you threaten me, show me a photo of my dead cousin, my family. I got at least 10 years in here to figure out exactly how to fuck with you and everything you care about.
Fuck you! You don't give a fuck! I don't give a fuck neither, man. I don't give a fuck about you, fucker! Try me! Fucking try me and see what the fuck... Get the fuck off me! You try me!
Vintage, and you may serve it up.
See any specials? We have grilled squab with a sweet potato foie gras spring roll with a wild huckleberry sauce. We also are offering raised sweetbreads with a white truffle sauce on cracked bulgur.
Cracked bulgur? You know, my mouth has been screaming for some cracked bulgur all week. Can we have a couple of minutes to look at the menu?
Oh, sure. Take me some minutes.
Man can't live on cracked bulgur alone.
Nice place, huh?
So we're gonna go to Tahiti. Did you say yes?
That is a yes.
Oh, we're going to Tahiti. They're not gonna be there. They ain't gonna never see us no more. Let's toast it to Tahiti, to being naked in Tahiti. Come on, say it. Naked in Tahiti.
Naked in Tahiti.
Not naked in Tahiti.
That's how I say it.
Naked.
Naked.
There you go. Say naked in Tahiti. Oh, let me fix you naked.
Oh, look at the sun bouncing off your head.
It's not here by 5, it's not my problem. I don't talk to me about Mitch. I'm running this shit about Mitch. I don't care.
And hello.
Then I'll rack him. Yeah, well, you got the memo from Clinton City Hall, too, right? I've got him right here.
No, they went down at 9:32, San Bruno. Yeah, they've got the old forms. Their form says I'm on bail or something. 91, 92, I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah, well, don't give me any grief about it. No, Frank, though. You can't screw me with my notes, okay?
That's it. Well done.
Yeah. Well, you can tell. sell that to Mitch, too. Okay? Don't call me on this anymore. Yeah, well, don't give me any grief about that. Why don't you guys keep going?
Still hurting from reading that movie.
Troy, I've got food for you. Troy. Where are you? Scotty.
Again, you haven't you? Scott, what is it?
Corda escaped.
Corda's escaped?
This morning.
You don't think you're trying...
I'm just a little on edge. I need to relax. I'm sure you're gonna try to get out of town and we leave it tomorrow anyway, you know? I'm sorry about that. I just overreacted, okay? Okay? Woo! Don't feed the dog before we have Cujo on.
Sure you didn't forget your bowling ball or your...
I said that ahead, you wise guy.
You're bringing a lot of clothes to a place where you're not supposed to wear a lot of clothes.
Hey, honey, don't you think it'd be better if you stayed in the house and ready to get out of here?
I'm not going to stay here and help you guys.
No, I'm not playing. I think you should go in the house, you know.
Hold up a second. We are going to Tahiti. We're going to have a great time, and you are...
Roper, what's up? What is it?
You missing something, Roper? I got it. You got something that belongs to me, and I want it back. 4:15 tomorrow. Mayor Island, north entrance off Dixon. They pull up the berth 16. Someone just smell another cop. I'll be sending you pieces of it for a month.
He's gonna kill her no matter what. If I take him those jewels, he's gonna kill me and her.
So what do you wanna do?
Scott, we go back a long ways, but you can't expect me to do this.
Right, this guy's a psychopath and he has Ronnie. It's the only way I'm gonna get close to him.
Then go to the lieutenant or the DA with her, for Christ's sakes. This is my fucking job. You're asking me to lay on the line.
I'm gonna prove it, and you know that. If I get the department involved in this shit, she's dead. This guy's a fucking maniac. You kill Sam, you kill her. I got one shot at this guy, Frank. What if it was Mary? You know, you do the same thing. You'd make me fucking ruin a book. Wouldn't you?
This conversation never happened. I never saw you today. Say hello. Shit. Open your shirt.
I'm not wearing a wide. It's between me and you.
Fuck you. Open a shirt.
Okay?
There you go.
I need help. You satisfied?
satisfied?
Open a bag, dump it on the table.
Yeah, stolen.
It ain't gonna look too good in the old service record.
You let me worry about that. Let's just get this shit over, all right?
Man after my own heart. There you go. Fill it up.
Damn.
Stay inside. Stay here.
So blue and sea so clear. This place is amazing.
Yep, I can really get used to this paradise shit.
Oh, excuse me, miss.
We can go to the room, I take off my clothes and run around naked for you. And incidentally, that thong in the suitcase, that's not getting worn on the beach, sorry.
Yeah, I'm very disappointed. You didn't even try it on. I bought it for you.
That's for me? Imagine me in some shit like that. You actually bought that for me?
It was a cute
on your ass.
Right here. Girl, please. One of my mother's friends was down here seeing me walking around in that shit.
Don't put your mother into this.
That's a small world. Somebody that knows my mother see me in that shit, then they, ooh, girl, Miss Roper's son be on the beach at Tahiti with his ass out on his vacation watching girl. Ooh, I think he had a string up his ass. Get the fuck out of here. Not today.
This is for the $100 bills.
When you come to me, you say you love me. When you tend to go, you make up the story. The broken heart you brought to my life. The bitter tears of a shameful life. Why you lied to me at the day you came? And why did you give me unreal dreams of? And I can't accept your